So I'm Jonathan Shrier. I'm from the U.S. Department of State, where I'm the Acting Special Representative for Global Food Security. And I'm delighted to talk to you about Feed the Future, which is the U.S. government's Global Hunger and Food Security Initiative. Back in 2009, President Obama announced that the U.S. would be devoting $3.5 billion over 3 years to help strengthen food security and reduce hunger around the world, and that we would do this through a strategic program of investment in agricultural development and other measures that help improve the ability of people to get food that they need. And doing this will raise rural incomes. It will also improve nutrition throughout the countries that we're working in. Back in 2009, we identified 20 countries that we would work in. Nepal, by the way, is one of those countries. And these are the countries where we're intending on focusing our efforts. For each of these countries, we've been working to develop multi-year strategies of how it is that we want to that we can invest in lasting food security. And that involves looking at the key parts of the agricultural economy that we can invest in and thinking about them in an integrated value chain way. And what that means is that in contrast to agricultural development efforts of the past, which sometimes just focused on the yield in the field, how much grain you produced or how much corn or maize you were able to produce, now we're making sure that we're thinking about the entire economic value chain that supports agriculture. And so that involves looking at the inputs, seeds, fertilizers, and so on, looking at the new technologies that can contribute to agricultural productivity in the field, but also looking at the transportation linkages that connect those producers to markets, looking at the enterprises, the businesses, the small businesses especially, that can grow up and get involved in food processing or transportation or other services to agriculture, and also looking at the consumer end of the picture, because ultimately, in many developing countries, there is a great need for better nutrition at the table in the family home. That's what Feed the Future is about.
What is the importance of this program for Nepal?
Well, so for Nepal, it's important because Nepal, like many of the countries that we're working in, is a primarily agricultural-based economy. And so if we can improve the agricultural sector, we will raise incomes and improve the economy as a whole, while also ensuring that people have enough food to eat and that they lead healthier lives because they have better nutrition. One of the ways that we're doing this in Nepal and elsewhere is through a focus on gender. And that's actually one of the reasons why I'm here in New York, because of an event that Secretary Clinton is hosting later today, which I can tell you about if you'd like.
Do you have office in office? You present the office in Nepal, or like?
Sure. In Nepal, we have a U.S. embassy with an ambassador, and also a U.S. Agency for International Development, or USAID mission, which is led by the mission director. Feed the Future, one of the things about it from a U.S. government perspective is that this is a whole of government effort. That means it's not just a U.S. Agency for International Development effort acting alone. The full force of the U.S. government is behind this. It's a presidential initiative. The State Department is involved. The U.S. Department of Agriculture is involved. Other parts of the U.S. government, the Department of Health and Human Services contributes on the nutrition side, for example. And so it is a whole of government effort.
Well, like in Nepal, like there is two, three kind of place. So some place they don't have any food, and some place they don't have like healthy food, and some place they have like food, healthy food. They don't know which is the healthy food, and they don't know which is the unhealthy food. Like, what kind of program do you have? Like,
right.
What is the further program for Nepal? Can you tell us in detail? What is the further program in future?
So I can tell you that the program in Nepal was carefully designed, taking into account all of those factors that you just mentioned. And so it combines work on helping to improve productivity in the parts of the country that are effective at producing food products, grain and so on, and also diversifying the production so that it's not just about filling bellies, but filling people's nutritional needs, so that we look at ways of improving the micronutrients, the vitamins and minerals in food, in a person's food basket. That's actually one of the areas where women play an especially important role. If I could, I'd like to just share with you some of the thinking that we've been doing about women in agricultural development. That's the topic of a panel discussion that Secretary Clinton is hosting and that will be taking place later today here in New York. That event comes out of the Secretary of State's interest in making sure that we keep a close eye on the importance of women in the economy. Secretary Clinton gave a speech recently at an APEC summit on women in the economy, and she pointed out that if the world economy is to grow out of the current difficulties, we need all parts of the population contributing, and that means making sure that that we remove any obstacles to the full participation of women in economic development. This is a participation age, she said, and in a participation age, we need to make sure that we're giving full play to the power of women as an engine of economic growth. And what we found in the agricultural sector is that if you give women access to land, to seeds, to credit, money, technology, and training, they can significantly increase agricultural output, which contributes to food security. So the Food and Agriculture Organization has found that if you give women equal access to these inputs to agricultural production, they can increase their output by 20 to 30%, which can increase national output in developing countries by as much as 4%, which could increase the number of people fed by on the order of 150 million people. So this is something that really matters. But doing this, unlocking that potential, requires a change in the way we think about these things, and it requires political will. And that's why it's so exciting that Secretary Clinton is bringing together people from government, like the president of Tanzania, from industry, the CEO of Unilever, a major multinational corporation, and from civil society, the head of an organization of self-employed women in agriculture from India, SEVA, bringing all these sectors together to talk about the importance of gender and women's role in agricultural development is a very exciting topic. The Feed the Future program that we were talking about before integrates gender into all of our work. And we're particularly focusing on four areas. Those are leadership, ways that women and women can lead in agricultural development; policy reforms, such as access to credit, access to land; thirdly, technology, so that women producers are able to adopt the technologies that can increase production and reduce the need for unpaid work. For example, when a woman has to go and bring water from her family from afar, if she has technology to get the water at her home, such as a cistern for collecting rainwater, she doesn't have to do that unpaid work. And fourthly, agriculture-based programs to improve nutrition, and this includes things like increasing the use of crops that have higher nutritional content, so that it's not just empty calories, it's calories with nutrition. To do this, we need to, if we care about doing this, we need to be able to measure our results. What we care about, we need to be able to track, to monitor. And that's another really remarkable feature of the Feed the Future effort, is the emphasis on monitoring and evaluating our results. in some areas, there just isn't good data available. And when there's not good data available, we don't just throw up our hands and say, we can't track this because there's no good data available. We go out and we find the data. We develop the tools for tracking what we want to measure. And in the field of women in agriculture, we're in the process of rolling out an innovative, first of its kind, Women's Empowerment Index for Agriculture. And this is being developed by the U.S. government in cooperation with the International Food Policy Research Institute and Oxford University through the Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative. And this index will measure women's role in household decision-making around agricultural production. It will look at women's access to productive capital. It will measure women's income. And it will measure women's leadership roles within the community. And it will measure how women spend their time at work, what their labor allocation is. And by doing this, we'll be able to see where the problems lie in terms of using the full potential of women to contribute to economic growth in agricultural economies, and what the impact is of our programs and initiatives. I should add that the programs that we pursue through Feed the Future are not just something that come out of the U.S. Agency for International Development or other parts of the U.S. government in Washington. These are programs that are based on the developing countries' own national plan for agricultural development. So in the case of Nepal, you've been developing a national country investment plan for agriculture. And our efforts are intended to support your efforts, your government's efforts, your society's efforts to improve agricultural productivity and the whole agricultural economy to support better incomes, better nutrition, better food security.
In Nepal, the political condition is not stable. Government are changing in every 3 months, 6 months. That kind of situation affects your program in Nepal?
Well, it's a challenge anywhere for any effort by governments working together to improve the livelihoods of people. And so we hope that things are able to be to stabilize so that programs like ours can continue to be effective.
What do you want to say to Nepalese people at last about this program? To Nepalese people, what do you want to say?
The United States has embarked on this effort to help feed the future of humanity. Because of something that really is part of our national DNA, our national makeup. We care, and we care for many reasons. We care because people who are no longer hungry can be more productive. We care because people who are no longer hungry can build stronger societies. We care because the future of humanity depends on a healthy, productive human race. And that's why we've invested in feeding the future.
Do you want to say something for Nepalese leader who are changing governments in 6 months, 3 months, political condition is not stable? For your program, you want to say something to this Nepalese leader?
We're not here. As I say, the United States is concerned to support the Nepalese people in improving their livelihoods, and we are hopeful that Feed the Future can succeed and in contributing to that effort.